Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Well, good morning, Sturgis High School. Mr. Walker here. Happy Friday. Something I wanted to show you. About 5 years ago, when I was feeling a little down because of some problems we were having on campus, I got this mason jar from Miss Lim's Avid class, and it's called Encouragements for Mr. Walker. They saw that I was down, needed an uplift, and they filled this jar filled with positive notes that I could pull out at any time and read. The reason I wanted to show that to you is that all of us have some down days, even here at a great place like Cerritos High School. And we have people on our campus we call mental health professionals who are here to support you when you have those down days. And we hired a brand new one for this year, Miss Araceli Matthews. Let's meet her right now. All right, good morning, Cerritos High School. Mr. Walker here with another version of Meet the Teach via Google Meet, though it's not quite a teacher that we're going to meet today. It's a new hire here that we have at Cerritos High School. She is our newest mental health provider, Ms. Araceli Matthews. Ms. Matthews, how are you doing this morning?
Fine, thank you, Mr. Walker.
Great. Well, we wanted to introduce you to the Cerritos High School family and had a few questions for you to kind of get to know you a little bit. First question I had for you is just, can you tell us about your journey here to Cerritos High School?
Well, I'm a product from our district because I attended junior high and high school here, but we won't mention the high school. I was also a teacher's aide, and I also did my student teaching at a different high school. But I also was a liaison for almost 16 years. So I am now blessed that I am now employed and looking forward to continuing working. I've been here about less than a month, and I really enjoy the staff, administration, and the students.
Great. And I'd have to say, very wise for you not to mention that high school. Keep in mind, here at Cerritos, we never wear blue. We avoid wearing blue. That's just what we do around here.
All right. Yes.
Tell us about your family, Ms. Matthews.
I have a college student who is my daughter, and I have a wonderful gentleman in my life. I have supporting family that are in the educational field. My mom and my aunts, all five of them, were teachers. So it's we're very close. And I live in the area, and I grew up in Lakewood, so I love to be in the community, and I'm very familiar with the resources here and what's available to help us better. Thanks.
Great. So where's your daughter going to college?
She's going to Long Beach State.
Great. I was going to say she's a 49er, but they're no longer the 49ers. They're now the Sharks, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Speaking of Sharks, I'm not talking about those in the ocean. We're talking about the Sharks on the athletic field. Do you have a favorite sport or sports team at all that you follow?
I follow the Lakers.
Okay.
Yes.
Good year for you then, right?
I love the Dodgers, but I'm an Angel fan.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm sorry about the Angel fan. It's been a while, right? 2002, I think, was their last
year. Yes, rub it in.
But a good year for LA sports, for sure. And we always root, no matter, I think Angel fans still root for the Dodgers if they're in that final game, for sure.
That's true.
Do you have musical tastes? Any...
I like the pop, I like the rock, I even like the rap. I mean, I like what they express sometimes, just classical music. I grew up playing piano, accordion, and the guitar. So since the age of four, So we're musically inclined, and you know, there's a lot of nice music out there that tells stories, and I really like that when the kids are listening to that. Yeah.
Great. Well, you know, we do have a staff band that performs at least once a year out there in the quad. They may be in search of an accordion player. Is there a favorite artist that you have out there, a band or an artist that you'd consider?
Well, I'm a little older, so I like U2. I like Aerosmith. And I was very, very hurt that and very saddened about the loss of Eddie Van Halen. Yeah, but I mean, Madonna and Rihanna, maybe. Yeah, there's a lot of them. Yeah.
What we would call classic rock, what our students call oldies, just letting you know. Finally, what about food? Favorite food? If you went out to a restaurant, what genre of food would you select as your favorite cuisine?
I love a lot of pasta. I love, because my daughter's half Italian, and I love the pasta. I love I love a lot of Mexican food. I'm really flexible. We have a variety in our family, and although I don't know how to cook, but I like to go buy stuff and I like to go and be invited. So I'm more than happy to participate there.
Great. Oh, our one new math teacher, Mr. McGrew, apparently his wife makes excellent Mexican food. So
well, take notes. I need to go there.
All right. Finally, I've closed with all our new teachers and new staff members with a kind of a creative question. So imagine, if you will, you are stranded on an island. You have everything you need in regards to survival, so the food and water and shelter and whatnot. What two items would you bring to that island, considering you're stranded there?
Okay. First of all, I would probably bring my phone, which is connected to internet, TikTok, Instagram, so I could communicate with the world. But I would have to have a long extension so I don't have to worry about having it charged or anything, because I need to keep and communicate. I could read books, I could listen to music, I could, you know, do lesson plans and what have you. So I love that. Another thing, well, you said I had everything, but my favorite, and I'm addicted to chocolate.
Chocolate.
Oh! So it had to be my Reese's chocolate and Hershey's. I would have to have a bundle of that. All That's right. My favorite.
Great. Well, I'll tell you, probably like most of our students who can't live without their phones, that would have been the first on their priority list, no doubt as well. Well, we are so glad to have you part of our team.
Glad
to introduce you to our student body and your colleagues and staff members that we haven't yet met because we're in this virtual environment. But you provide a great service for us, and I know that you're out there to assist all of our students with their social emotional needs. So thanks for joining us today, and have a great day.
You too. Thank you, Mr. Walker. Bye.
All right. Well, I hope you enjoyed meeting Miss Araceli Matthews. Remember, students, that we understand here at Cerritos High School that your social emotional well-being is important to contributing to your academic success, and we are here to support you in those areas. Have a great day.